Right then, everyone. There's a farm there. I don't know what it's called. There's a back entrance. I came down from further over up that way. Been a long way. I couldn't even tell you what video this was now. But over there we've got Brent Knoll. We're on a flat bit for a little while now. There's Brent Knoll. They had three crosses up there over Easter. I always put them up there. Quite often in the past I've run out of film while I've got here, or I've only had enough for some photos. I've got a feeling this is mustard. Mustard plants this yellow stuff. I'm not sure, I ought to find out. If not, it's kale. It's one of them. It might be kale. Anyway, I've got a nice flat walk. I'm going to end up on hill up there eventually. Or over the side of that hill, I should say. Over the side. See, you can, where I was up there earlier, right up there, where that secluded farm was, I could have taken another route, which would take me along what's called the Roman Road up the top there, and then took a pathway and come down further up and come down into Bleadon that way. And I did that last year. I reckon I did that last year. But I usually do this walk, not all from Winscombe, like I've said, but this will be incorporated in other walks I do. And there's lots of farm buildings out here. Like I said, I didn't think it's this warm, but I got my jumper, I got my windshield. That sounds like a peacock making that noise. I reckon that's a peacock. I can't think what else would do that. Now, we just got to keep our fingers crossed they haven't got any cows in these fields. Otherwise, it could be a case of backtracking, which my legs probably can't cope with. Or we take the risk. We take the risk. Yeah, there's a big farm up here, but was a cow farm. Then it deteriorated for a little while. Then it was tidied up quite a bit, and old machinery and barns either got rid of or repaired. The cows disappeared because they always used to have cows. I can't see any sign of any cows at the moment. So whether it's just been turned into a residence now, I mean, someone could have their mechanic's garage out there, couldn't they? Really, you know, have a different, completely different business this day and age. It's where you've got outbuildings, you can use them for all sorts of things. What with them, there being problems, farmers being able to afford to do it anymore. But of course, if we're not in Europe, if we're not going to be in Europe, we're going to have to start. The farmers are going to have to start wanting to be farmers again. They lost heart, you see, when they weren't getting paid for their milk quotas and all that. I think they've lost out on subsidies now. I think they did get subsidies while they were in Europe. So some of them are going to be out of pocket for that reason. They can't have it always, can they? Yeah, they did put a series of gates in as well over the past. And look, that's a brand new sign. Look how yellow that is. There won't be a West Mendip sign because we're not on the West Mendip way here. Another thing, just to let people know, there are public conveniences at Bleadon near the village hall, which is also where you can get fill your water bottle up if you have to. I think it's safe to drink that water. I've had to do it, but I try not to drink it. I'm not quite sure, but I think it is safe to drink. Yeah, Brent Knoll, some lovely views here, isn't there? But like I said, it's lost the blue sky a bit now. The tide must be coming in, there's a breeze. And like I say, I don't really know if there's any cows out or not. I don't really know. I see somebody with a dog walking up there. We'll be going that hill up there. Just zoom in. Right there. I'll be climbing up that in a minute. Going across it and then down into Bleadon where the church is. Then I'll walk through Bleadon. Out near the anchor inn. And then make my way through an old road. That's more residential now used for. And then I've got the walk, quite a hike towards uphill. Unless I decide at the Anchor Inn to catch a bus. If not, I'll wait till I get to uphill. Now I'm just going to zoom in on top of that hill there. See, you might be able to just make out a couple of cows. Now that herd there is the ones I said hello to about three or four videos back. They've been put out now and they've got quite a big space to play in. But that's that herd. So you have to be very careful where you went if you started freelancing up there walking about. Because I can't see a cow anywhere. Someone's been digging the ditches here, look. See, somebody might decide to build on that. So that's a nice bit of paddock there, isn't it? Imagine you could put a house there. Like I say, if you're watching and listening to my video, you could turn it off, put it on pause and go and make a cup of tea now. I do get people watching now. It's a bit like EastEnders or Coronation Street. It's Sheila on her walk. Probably a bit boring. I just better repeat myself a bit. The thing is, I've got to keep going. I can't sort of think, oh, I can't go any further. I'm not going any further. I've got to. Do you know what I mean? So you have to look around for things to stimulate your brain as well. There's plenty of that. But when you start feeling a bit tired, you know, I'm 65, but I'm determined to still keep on trying to get out and do some of these walks. But I know that they will shrink. I will have to do, instead of doing the whole of what I've done today, I could split it in two and then do one bit one day. And, you know, I can still do these walks, but I might have to, when I'm, I don't know yet, I might be still able to do this when I'm 90. I can't see it, but I can't see me being able to do the whole of it, put it that way. Not like today, so I'm still a youngster. And there will be young people who would find this a lot. Especially those that aren't used to walking. I've got very strong legs. I did have a bit of problem with my feet after wearing wellies on quite a big hike, which was a mistake. Wellies with no heel supports. nothing to cushion the foot inside. It was awful. I'm still suffering from that from about a fortnight ago. Ah, I can see sheep. Now, last week I was on a walk, going through a big sheep field. But what was in there? What was in there? A great big hairy bull with huge curly horns. So, basically, there might be sheep in there. There could be a bull in there. They're doing that to stop people nicking the sheep. They sometimes put horses in with sheep as well. These are bar lambs. See, they built this whacking great trough. There's been sheep in here. This is all sheep dung, then they're small like that. Sheep dung. Look at this massive trough. Like a giant bath, isn't it? Now, of course, we are allowed to walk through here. Well, I'm going to be very careful because I know there's lambs. Oh, I just zoom in. I've seen a glider. One of those motorised gliders. Where is it? I can't see it now. No, I can't see it, but it's up there somewhere. It's one of those motorised gliders. But it's a bit too bright for my eyes staring up there. I can't focus. Right, so we're now going into another field that used to be cows. Because I can remember they all used to gather up round the gate ready for milking. This is a huge nursery, isn't it? My goodness, there's a lot of them here. Hi, bear lambs. Hi, sheepies. I hope they don't attack, because the thing is, they're protective of their little sheepies as well. There's Mum watching. There's a lot of them. I'm just surveying to see if I can see a bull. Nothing. You what, they all go bloody crazy when I enter. I won't be the only person. It's a public footpath. Hi there, sheepies. Don't worry, I'm just going to walk straight past. I'm not going to hurt you. It's all right, you don't have to move, Mum. Looks like she's panting away. Maybe she's having some more. She might not have, they might not be hers. And of course, there's all bleeding houses. I can remember taking my bike up a very steep, dangerous track up there. I always used to have to stop and have me water and have a breather. I am going to try and go out on my bike again, you know. I'm going to start by driving to Yatton and with the bike in the back and just do small cycles again. Because I need some jelly pants, really. Wonder why they haven't bothered with the cows. It's all right, babies. Look at that one. I think they get fed sort of sheep food in these buckets, like with nuts and stuff in them. You know, not nuts, but it's condensed food. Wonder if they can reach the water in there. There's one black sheep right at the top. Out of all the slot, one black lamblet. Or it could be a sheep. Lamb, I think. Oh, look at those two meeting each other. Bet they're brother and sister, I spat. That sheep back there don't look very well. It's not... I wonder if it was easier having sheep. Obviously, you breed the lambs and then they kill the lambs. You know, that's why we have lamb, leg of lamb. See, I can just see the leg of lamb there on that one. You know what I mean? Hello? Hello? Right? Oh, look at you. Look at you. Well, like I said, this could be the first time I've seen sheep in here. So, like I said, every time I come out, something changes. Now, we used to be able to go through the farm. Now, it's a good job I've got that recorded on other videos in the past, because you can't go through the farm anymore. You have to bypass the farm. Now, instead of going up that way, they now call it private land, so that we can't go near the barns and everything. We have to go up through there. Oh, I wonder how you get that up then. Well, maybe it's this one we open. That's it, yeah. Yeah, we used to be able to walk through the farm, and I've got some lovely videos of all the old machinery and the old barns. But you're not allowed now, see? And like I said, there's no cows anymore. Looks like you can still go that way and bypass, probably. Because there's a bridge over there. You can't see it from here. You can walk across the field here, get up on the bank there, and then you can go on a bridge that'll take you across, and then you can walk up and get the bus from there, see? It is another route. But I'm not doing it today. I'm not doing any exploring in that area. Maybe I don't really do cows at all now. They found a way through, little cheekers. Oh, look at that though. I turn round thinking there's no cows, and look, what do I see in there? My goodness, you've got a little tiny pen now, haven't you? Wow. Look at that. And there's a bull. The white one is a bull. He's got a ring in his nose. The one behind that brown one is a bull with a big furry head. See? He's looking over at me. He's a bull. Fortunately, they can't get in this field. Not a very big bull, though. He's a white bull. Right, I'm going to turn off for a minute and take some pictures of the cows here. At least they're not in here, as far as I know. And I can take a picture. What's wrong with it? Why won't it bloody on?